Hello and welcome to Busy Works Beats. .com. We're back at it. I need you to smash that like button so we can get rocking today. Today I'm really, really excited. Last night I stayed up till probably 4 a.m. Just to research like new plugins and new sounds. So firstly, I want to shout out MG The Future and his channel on YouTube. Super high tech. You need to subscribe immediately to his channel. But he just put up a video about Scalar 2 and it opened up my eyes. So before, I used to think that Scalar was a plugin to try and like teach you music theory. A lot of people tried to say, oh, it teaches you music theory. And I just think that's not the right way to explain Scalar the way I would use it. But then Scalar 2 came out. And if you guys know anything about the Karma engine inside the Korg Kronos, basically what it means is you can hit one key and it will start doing a bunch of stuff for you, like arpeggiate the notes or play like a real piano player. So you can play a chord, just holding a chord, and then it will start doing like, it'll sound like you're actually playing up and down the keyboard, even though you're just holding your hands. So that's what Scalar 2 has incorporated in the new software, from what I understand. They've incorporated that you can just play notes, and then those notes will perform for you as if you're a real piano player. Whereas Scalar 1, the way I used to use it was just to identify scales. I didn't use it to teach me music theory. You will pick up some language from it, but I wouldn't like think that this is going to be your music theory education program. I just can't say it's that, because it's not that to me. All right. So firstly, it's a lot involved. Now I want to shout out everybody who's a part of this. Let's see if we see any familiar names over here. I heard Curtis King has some chords in here. Let me see who else is up in here. Can't read from back here. We got MG The Future has some chords in here. His chords are actually dope. Go to Neptune Land. That's my favorite chord progression that I've heard. And I don't know. I think Multiplier. I remember him from YouTube. And who else? I don't know the rest of the folks. But those folks are a part of this. And basically, they contributed chord progressions to it. So let's get it rocking. Let's see how we can apply this to trap. I'm going to make this super simplified. I'm not going to make it music theory and ease talk, because I found the other videos, they didn't do a good job really explaining like how we're going to use this without speaking music theory and ease. So firstly, the way I used to use Scalar was to identify a scale. So let me pull up some folders, and let's say there was a song like this. And let's say I wanted to find notes to match the song. What I used to do was go to detect mode and hit record. Now they changed the starting piano, so it's a little harder to hear. Let me trash this real quick. So let's say you like that song and you want to add more instruments, or you want to like remix it or whatever. You're basically trying to find the key. Now I also want to see, once we get to it, I'll get to it. But hit, just turn the song on, and then what you do is you hit record and then go to detect mode, and then you start playing notes. It's a little hard to hear. Okay, so this tells me all the notes that I heard, even though it's very, 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 very soft. And again, I don't know why they swapped out that starting piano. It's just almost too soft to hear for whatever reason. I guess they wanted it to sound pleasing, but what was I gonna say? So once you click all the notes that you hear in another song, it tells you the exact scale. Now this, again, I'm just giving you my raw experience. It's a little difficult to see, so you might have to make it a little bit bigger, but it looks like they made it so where you can left click and drag, which is dope. Okay, so now I can see. So the notes put together are these scales and modes. Now the reason you're getting multiple results is because scales are just the combination of notes that sound good. Now, the difference between each of these names is where you start. So if I start on A and I go up the keyboard, where the tonal center, it's called, is A. Now we're speaking music theory and ease. Or the wherever you start is going to be the tonal center, or the key, so to speak. So that's why the first scale they give you is A minor. Because I think I started the detection on A. Now, I could have been wrong if I didn't start on A. It could just be ranked based on the most popular names for scales as well. But without digging too deep into music theory, also the same notes in C major are the same exact notes in A minor. It's just the only difference is where you start. So if I start on C and I count up the keyboard, it gives me C major. So that's, it's just ranking, I guess, the more popular scales. So I don't, it put a list of like a gazillion scales, but it just shows how much similarity is in the scales. Oh, you know what it tells you right here? Notes, 2 out of 7. Okay, I just noticed that. Notes, 7 out of 7. So all these 7 out of 7s are going to be your pure exact notes. All that means is just pick the top one, okay? Just, long story short, pick the top one without confusing you to death. But that's how I do that. I'll play like to a lot of older R&B songs. Now, if I were you, I would switch this to grand piano. It's just a lot easier to hear because that other piano was so soft. We could not hear it over the music. So let's put it on grand piano. Okay, and it tells you the scale here. And it tells you the mood. So this A minor scale is serious, sad, emotional, sentimental. So it lets you know the potential mood for your song as well. So that's how I used to use Scalar. Now, Scalar has evolved to do a lot of cooler things. Now, again, there's a lot more functionality to it. I just don't use all the functionality. Okay, so here's a new thing that they let you do. Now, the thing about this is, actually, before we even get into what I'm about to say, let's just focus on the scales. So let's just hit record and let's just play some notes. So boom. Okay, so now we're in the C minor scale. So they have a mode, and I'm trying to figure out how to activate this mode. I guess when you play a chord. Okay, so once you map out the scale, what Scalar does is map out the chords. These are called scale degrees. You don't even need to know what that means. It just means it maps out the chords for each note in a scale. Okay, so if you wanted to expand it just beyond playing one note at a time, it figured out a way to pick chords for that specific scale. So you can start creating moods with the chords. And this is really fast. This is why I use Scalar as well, because it just quickly maps out scale degrees. I don't have to map out the scale, skip all the notes, and do all that tedious time work. It just does it for you. So it's more of a reference than it is a hack type of thing. It's a reference for me. Okay, so let's say you want to make this more jazzy. You would click where it says triads, click this the sevenths. Now, I'm not sure why it applies to all the chords, but I guess it's once you drag it down, it must lock in. So those sound more jazzy. Now, if you want real jazzy, go to ninth chords. I kind of like that. So let's, what you do from here is you left click and drag the chords in. So boom, boom, boom. Okay, you drag them in. So what it's doing is it's going to create a MIDI thing that you can drag into any other instrument. So I'll show you what that looks like in a second. But what we're doing is, okay, you start by playing the notes that you hear in a song. Then it tells you the scale. And a scale is the same thing as a key. Okay, so it's a C minor scale, or C minor is the key. So you click on C minor, that could be your answer right there. Then you can go back and just use those notes or map out your auto-tune, whatever it may be, or plug C minor into auto-tune. Then you roll down to the bottom. If you want to start creating chords from here, you can roll down to the bottom and it will map out the chords for this specific scale. Then what you do is you click this little thing to kind of cycle through the different chords. Now notice as I click backwards, it doesn't change the chords that I have down here. Because before you had to manually click on each thing, but they fixed that. Wait, let's see. Oh wait. So we have some really jazzy chords. Now we don't have to deal with the voicing and all this, the variation. You can mess with that if you want. What I want to learn is this new feature up here. So now that we have a chord progression, there's the thing that I said mimics the chord Kronos, something called a Karma engine, which means you can play this chord and then Scalar will start to make it sound like a piano player is playing it. So here's where we're going to go next. So I'm going to click up here where it says perform. Now from the videos I saw, I wish the language was a lot easier. I understand it's a proper language, but sometimes when you don't translate things, it just makes the user confused. So right now, if you go to perform mode, turn that on, then go to accento. I don't even know what accento means. You know, that doesn't mean anything to the average producer. So that's going to throw you off. I already know. But go to accento, go to performances, and then they used Italian language. Again, I'm not here to critique a plugin. I'm just telling you, this is what makes people confused. So I know this is the proper language, but sometimes you shouldn't use proper language. You should create your own. So anyway, it says Accento performances, and then apparently it goes from like more subtle to more busy. I forget what the guy said. You can go to the original video if I remember to link it, but go to performance, adagio, whatever, and just go to Accento. Again, I don't know why they use these names. But then when you click on the chord, it starts to play it out like a human would. This is going to save you so much time when it comes to your loop creations or your melodies. And it's going to give you more cool options other than just arpeggiator and FL. So let's take this further. Let's go to the performance mode. And again, all these are just like speaking alien. I don't know what any of these means. In my opinion, that was not a good decision on their part. But again, I bought the plugin. By the way, this is not a sponsored video, so I have the right to help them out. This is pretty dope. Now what you can do is go to voice groupings, and again, I have no idea what this means. I don't feel like reading the manual, so let's not worry about that. But let's go to humanize, and this means like, how do we make it sound more real? Then we're gonna click on both, and then now it kind of shifts the timing out a little bit and changes the velocity or how hard you hit a note so that it sounds more real. So the question from here is like, okay, now that we know that the plugin's doing all this cool stuff, we don't want to use the sounds in the plugin. We want to make our own sounds. So like, how do we take out this thing and then put it into our own thing? And that's where they've created this drag function for MIDI. Now, I'm not sure if we have to do MIDI capture mode, but let's just try dragging it first. So let's open up Hermes. And let's say we want a sound that actually is for trap music, not just like a piano or Rhodes or anything like that. So let's go to bells and let's lock in a random bell. Let's do palace bells. Okay, so once we have this, let's X out real quick. Let's go to scalar and let's go to where it says drag. Now here's where the screen should probably be a little bit tinier so I can see. Go to drag and then drag this over onto Hermes. Now it looks like, yeah, it looks like it added all the timing for us. But it looks like something's missing here. So I don't know what this little blip is. I'm not sure what that little blip is, but let's just delete the blips. Little microscopic blips in there. Now, is this the chord progression that we had? Let's kind of match that with what... I feel like the chord was a lot bigger. Not sure why it didn't copy all the notes. Maybe because I didn't do something. So just in case, let's do MIDI capture mode. Now recording MIDI. I have no idea what this does, but ready to drag MIDI. Okay, let's see if that did anything. Let's drag that into Hermes. Wonder why the notes aren't playing, like the whole chord. That's a little weird. Let me drag it into a different plugin, see if... this is odd. So, trying to figure out why it's doing that. So hopefully you won't have this experience either. This is so weird, because here are chords right here. So let's drag this again. So I don't know if this is some glitch, but unfortunately in FL at least, it's not doing what it's... I don't know, guys, I don't know. So I was hype about the plugin, but due to that part, again, I could be doing something wrong. So don't like butcher them for this, but from what I'm hearing, I don't... Let's do it this way. Let's try something else. Let's give them the benefit of the doubt. Let's go to loop mode, play, and then let's hit MIDI capture. So let's hit MIDI capture. So now it's recording this, whatever we play, and then hit play. All right, let's hit stop. This is super weird that it's not picking up all the notes. Let's drag this. And if this doesn't work, then I can't recommend this plugin. Yeah, something's going on. Don't know. Don't know what to tell you here. Well, I mean, I don't know what to tell you guys. Maybe if we turn this off, the humanize function, maybe that screwed it up. Dang, this is nuts. I haven't seen this for anybody else, so I don't know if this is like a specific user case or what. Let's take it off perform mode. I don't know, y'all. It's not working the way it's supposed to, in my opinion. So, don't know if I could recommend this right now. Looks like some, either it's a bug or not sure, but I bought it. Regardless, if you don't have scalar period, you still need it for the scale detection. This new piece up here is just brand new. I thought it was interesting, but dang, man, this really is not dragging the right MIDI. So I probably did something wrong. So don't take this as a hard fact, but do be precautious here because I just did it like four different ways and it didn't do anything. So don't know what to say about that, but let me know in the comments below if you're thinking about scalar too, and let me know. That's kind of like a whack ending to the video. I feel bad because we were going to make a dope track out of this, but until we figure that out, I just really can't recommend it right now. Oh, here we go. Wait, I might have been wrong. Wait a minute. Hold up. We have a saving grace. So apparently I had it on MIDI capture mode, so that's a human error. But you could probably make that same mistake too. So if you didn't know about that, you'd be like, what is going on? Okay, now we got what I think we should be having. Okay, now we got it. Okay, let's go to both. Turn that on. Let's drag this back into Hermes. Luckily, I didn't. It's like, oh, you know what? It's the humanize function. It's creating those little blips. Okay. So let's slow down the BPM a little bit. Okay, there we go. I was going to feel really bad if that didn't work because I was going to be like, wow, man, I really wanted to suggest this to you guys. Also, if you plan on getting this, use MG the Futures link. I don't have an affiliate link, but use his affiliate link because he put me onto Scalar too. So he deserves the credit there as far as like the affiliate thing. Because when you click the affiliate link, the people who helped you find out a dope plugin, they get compensated. So it's like my way of thanking MG, like, thank you for putting me onto this plugin. Let's go to a different sound here. Let me make sure this is actually playing the chord progression that I think, because I want to make sure it's playing the same thing as Inside. Is the plugin, I think it's like listening to itself and then it's on performance mode. So that's another little thing. If you drag the MIDI back into Scalar, it's going to listen back to itself and then re-perform over the notes that it just performed. So you want to make sure you turn that off. So it sounds right. Okay, so now we have the proper thing going. Now we can paste that into any other sound, like Hermes, for example. Now again, we're using a grand piano as a source sound, so it's... Let's trapify this. So I like that chord progression, very... Oh, did it not map out the last? Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, you know what, I forgot to drag that out. It's still 3 bars, that's weird. So let's take out that last chord. Also, let's try one thing. Let's drag this out to double the length. Either my brain is tripping or I'm tripping. Like, is my brain tripping? Because it should be slower. Oh, you know what? I dragged the MIDI in the wrong thing. I'm like, okay. So I was dragging the MIDI in Scalar just then. I was about to say, like, I know I'm not tripping. Let's drag this out. Okay, now we can go back and swap out the sounds. Okay, now we're doing it right. So there's a little learning curve to it. Because I honestly was about to not recommend it if it didn't work like that, but apparently I was doing something wrong. That last chord I don't like anymore, but... Now we have like a unique, so what this is going to do is unlock creativity, because this is stuff I couldn't think of, because I don't know every single scale, I don't know every single arpeggiation style. But what they've done is it's like a Legos in the plugin, it's like a Legos. So what we're doing is just putting different Lego pieces on, like it's like Minecraft. Actually, Legos is super old. It's like Minecraft. So on Minecraft, you have different tiles. You have the grass tile or the dirt tile. You have the, what is it, cobblestone tile. You have the, what other tile? You have, somebody help me in the chat. Cobblestone, you have dirt, you have the other tiles. I forget the other tiles for some reason. That's so weird. Haven't played Minecraft in a while. But then you can rearrange the tiles however you like using these different performance styles and different things. And you can rearrange the structures here. So, okay, now that I've figured out how to use the plugin, I can definitely recommend this. And again, don't use my link because I don't have a link. Use MG The Future's affiliate link in the link below, because that will give him credit for putting me onto the plugin. And he put me onto the plugin and I put you onto the plugin, hopefully. So I want all that credit to go back to him, because he deserves his fair share there for putting us on. All right, so let's try another preset right quick. I literally almost was like, yo, I don't know about this plugin, y'all. But hopefully they can understand through this video the user experience. Let's pull out some. This is my favorite lead. So now you have some really dope backdrops for your emotional trap records. Stuff that needs a little more musicality. And you don't have to be a player to now actually apply this stuff. So hopefully it was a little bit of a learning curve. But once we figured out what the issue was, it was the MIDI capture mode that I had on. That was the issue. But once we figured out what the issue was, it seems like everything was straight. Then you run this through your favorite plugins, of course. Let's just make it more modern. Let's do halftime. Then you can blend it. Okay, you can put reverse on it, whatever you want to do from here. All right, so I mean, from here, it's just infinite creativity. So thank you for watching today. We'll try and incorporate this new functionality a little bit more, because I'm starting to get into shortcuts. And I'll show you how to use a scaler too to make beats a lot faster. So we can continue the BeatStars journey and make like 100 beats in a second. And so we will have scaler 2 kind of performances. We can have loops and you can have a real session player play stuff. You can make beats way faster. So we'll get into all those hacks and workflows moving forward. But again, subscribe to MG The Future's channel. I would highly recommend it. And grab Scaler 2 with the link below. Again, that's his link. I need you guys to support him for putting us on, because our whole goal is lifting up ourselves so that we can do bigger things. All right. So thank you for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.